We've done a lot of work, and we'll still keep working. But we're crossing the final straight already. Yes, Ilso Raisuch, yeah, sure, I heard, right. Thanks a lot. You could say that University of Flame will be the brightest ever, or that will bring the most beautiful university face to the world. So, thanks again. Sure, we'll say hi to the guys. Mm-hmm. Take care. Watch on today. Will our national badminton team win Universiade medals? How to make chess the most popular kind of sport? Pavel Antipov, student national basketball team player, shares his opinion on must-visit Universiade competitions. Kazan Tennis Academy has been hosting Tatarstan Badminton Championship final this week. Me and Alex Chupin, Universiade Flame presenter, just couldn't do anything but find out what UNI TV program is the coolest. As we finished in the draw, 5-5, the winner was determined by a shootout.
Fatality.
From the 2nd to the 4th of June, Kazan Tennis Academy was hosting Tatarstan Badminton Championship Final. The tournament became the test event of the 27th Slama Universiade. Three Tatarstan athletes were included into the Russian national team. Pavel Famin, one of the possible team candidates, says our team can win the medals in team competitions. Our main competitors will be Asian badminton players. Badminton in Asian countries is almost as popular as football in the whole world. Of course, China is a leading country in badminton. Badminton matches gather full stadiums, there are crowds of fans always, they follow their stars all over the world and support them. And generally in the world, badminton is developing rather fast. So it's worth visiting badminton matches, at least in order to know more about the sport itself. Because the majority of people don't take badminton seriously. They think of it as a beach activity or something. But when professional players play badminton indoors, that's much more interesting. You can purchase badminton tickets at Tatarstan Badminton Federation. Badminton competitions during university games will take place since the 5th till the 11th of July. We decided to purchase all the tickets in order to distribute them among the kids and badminton sections all over the Republic. We hope they will come to watch the tournament and will become real fans. They will be able to see the real stars and there will be a good example for them. Moreover, they can watch Cirque du Soleil performances with this ticket on hand. So if you have any questions or requests, please contact our federation. We will provide all the possible help and necessary information. As we know, chess tournament will be taking place at Kazan Equestrian Complex during the University Games. Now imagine the final match, tough game, and the white wins due to the L-shaped mat. In fact, such mat is typical of scholars tournaments only. Chess Federation of the Tatarstan Republic was hosting Nizamuddinov Memorial Chess Tournament from the 31st of May till the 8th of June. This tournament has gained great popularity in the Republic. As for the university competitions, Kazan Equestrian Complex is giving the finishing touches before the Summer Games. Only the top chess players will arrive in Kazan. Among the grandmasters, there are some Russian players as well. Of course, all the players will be very strong. Well, maybe not every one of the 200 participants is a real professional, like top professional, because we are talking about the student games. But 5 or 7 countries participating are considered to be chess elite. Finally, we asked Kazan residents how to promote chess and make it more spectacular for viewers. I don't even know, maybe change the rules? Chess is good for memory. Maybe they need to somehow make it closer to the popular kind of sports such as football or basketball. No, it's not boring. I'm telling you, it's just for the memory. Maybe they need to launch an advertising campaign to attract people's attention, change the rules. Why? If they will be playing chess and someone will be fighting on the back, then yeah, this will work out. The rules are set already, so no need to add anything. It's like adding glare or tinsel. It's hard to oppose to the last answer, but if you have any better ideas, you can offer them by buying a ticket to chess tournament that will be held from the 9th till the 15th of July. In our last episode, we asked you to guess the name and the number of Rubin player whose shot I was dressed in. And here is the winner. So please contact us at 293-9366 and get your prize from Universiade Directorate and UNI TV channel. Watch more Universiade news next and a new context, as usual. Russian national student basketball team started preparing for the university games. One UNICS player, Pavel Antipov, was included into the national team as well. Before leaving for the training camp, he told us what Universiade competitions he was planning to visit during the games. I would like to visit athletics, because I was watching Olympic competitions last year and I was watching Usain Bolt and other athletes and I really liked it. Well, next, I guess tennis, because it's very beautiful and skillful. And I like chess too, because I was playing chess when I was younger and I still remember the rules and still remember how to play. And it's just interesting to see them playing. Of course, fencing, because I also was watching an Olympic tournament when our fencers were fighting against the French, or I might be wrong, and I realized that this sport is super precise and very sharp, so mistakes are not affordable for them, and you can watch them for hours. Well, table tennis too. The way they're moving their hands like super fast and just unthinkable. I can't get how they're doing it all, but it's so cool. Don't miss Universiade Faces featuring Pavel Antipov, where he shares on why it's necessary to come to Kazan. On the 9th and 11th of June, the football tournament among the Volga Federal District student teams will be taking place at Olymp and Trudovyi Rezervy stadiums. Teams from seven cities will take part in the tournament. Students of Kazan National Research Technical University, named after Tupolev, will represent Kazan. Finals will take place on Tuesday at Trudovyi Rezervy Stadium. The matches begin at 4 and 7 p.m. accordingly. On the 14th of June, Open Water Swimming Championship of the Tatarstan Republic will take place at the Rowing Center. The same day, Athletics Junior Championship will commence at the Central Stadium. The entry is free of charge. Don't miss it. Universiade Flame goes on traveling around Russia. Last week, the Flame was visiting Moscow, Perm, Ijevsk, Kirov, Nizhny Novgorod and Yushkarla. Next week, the relay will cover seven more cities and on the 20th of June will reach Tatarstan borders. Don't forget that Tatarstan residents have a unique opportunity to become a torchbearer at Kazan University Games. The contest is open till the 16th of June. To take part in the competition, entrants should submit their photos featuring them as an athlete in any of the 27 sports included in the Kazan 2013 Summer University Games sports program. The photo post should have a short message saying why this nominee deserves to be a torchbearer and collect likes. The photo should be later posted in the official groups of the 27 sports University Summer Games in VKontakte, Facebook and Instagram. That's all for today. Guess who of the Universiade ambassadors will be answering our questions in our next episode. And leave your answers under the video. I'm Adele Burganov. See you next week.